Could humans ever live entirely underwater, or are we forever confined to the surface? Our oceans cover over 70% of the planet, yet remain largely unexplored. So, what stops us from colonizing Earth's aquatic depths? Well, to begin with, the challenges are immense. The sheer pressure at deeper ocean depths would deform human organs. Water is 800 times denser than air. Just 10 meters down doubles the pressure you feel on your body. At 4,000 meters, which is the average depth of the ocean floor, the pressure would be like having a few cement trucks stacked on top of you. While our soft tissues would compress but likely survive, the bigger threat is gases. The air we breathe is roughly 80% nitrogen, which forms bubbles in tissues under high pressure. Ascend from the depths too quickly, and these bubbles expand to clog blood flow, causing excruciating pain from the bends. Organisms thriving in harsh, deep ocean environments are largely unknown to us. Pitch black, cold waters teem with otherworldly creatures perfectly adapted to such extreme conditions. What impact would a human presence have on these barely understood ecosystems? Small undersea habitats like the Aquarius Laboratory can host humans temporarily at significant depth, but inhabitants only stay for weeks, slowly decompressing when surfacing to avoid the bends. True underwater living would require fundamentally re-engineering the human body. So, while we can descend briefly with submersibles or saturation dive gear, our physiology is designed for the terrestrial world. Until we can biologically adapt humans to withstand crushing pressures and the alien seascape, extensive underwater living will remain a science fiction dream. For now, Earth's final frontier, our own uncharted oceans, must be explored with care, using robots and limited human access. What we discover may one day allow outposts under the sea, but the surface remains our true and logical home. Although bodily challenges preclude underwater living for now, some visionaries foresee a sci-fi future where humans are genetically or cybernetically altered to survive the depths of our planet. Imagine submarine cities on the seafloor, farming among kelp forests, or mining rare minerals from hydrothermal vents. As fantastical as this seems, if humanity exhausts its surface resources, tapping the oceans could become a priority. This could lead to an extreme transformation that might alter us into an entirely new species, provided that we evolve to thrive underwater. Moreover, if the technical and logistical challenges were solved, could humans psychologically adapt to life underwater? Our brains are wired to a 24-hour circadian cycle, visual horizons, and the stimuli of an above-water world. A profound shift in perception would be required to become an aquatic species. The ocean's alien nature terrifies us to this day. But eons ago, the first fish crawled onto primordial shores, pioneering the terrestrial niche we now enjoy. Perhaps one day, humans will make the return trip, completing our planet's saga by transferring civilization back to the nurturing womb of the sea.